Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to SmackDown Live. My name is Dave East, alongside commentary experience is Tim Price.
Oh yes, it is great to be here for Wolby and yet again another jam-packed edition of SmackDown. You do not want to miss anything that we have going ahead.
We are continuing to be in Canada, of course, ladies and gentlemen. And remember, if you were with us on main event, we are heading towards a draft. We'll get into that a little bit later on, of course. But we're going to start things off with the Intercontinental Title Tournament Final. Bobby Hall is going to take on Finn Balor. Who is going to meet Gilberto at Backlash? We will find out next on SmackDown Live.
What a huge way to kick things off at the finals of the Intercontinental Title Tournament to determine our number one contender. And do not go anywhere.
And remember, as we've seen, ladies and gentlemen, Gilberto awaits the winner. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, being accompanied by the Good Brothers, Carl Anderson, and...
You've got his name.
Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows.
He's
Finn Balor. Finn Balor. Finn Balor, the Irish version. Thanks for that. You could have helped us out.
Nah, it's all right.
You wouldn't get this anywhere else.
Finn Balor, because, you know, has gone through a tough tournament to get to the finals here. So we'll see if he'll get to face Gilberto at a Backlash of the Intercontinental Championship. Finn Balor now very close now, but he's got to get past a very tough opponent in Bobby Hall, who's also gone through grueling matches to get to the finals. What an opener we have here tonight.
And you could see as well, Tim, that Luke Gallows on the brain. Finn Balor and Bobby Hall have had a resurgence in season 7. Could this be, well, really, the final push for both men here tonight? And of course, Gilberto waits at Backlash.
Yeah, really could be. It's just a final push to get to Gilberto. I mean, it'll be, you know, it's tough for them if, you know, whichever one wins, because the Backlash to then unfortunately not succeed there. But that's, you know, Gilberto is hoping for himself. You know, he's going to be watching this match very closely backstage. See, you know, see any kind of weakness in who's going to be his challenger.
And his opponent, ladies and gentlemen, he is the mysterious Bobby Hall.
Yeah, of course, yeah, Bobby always saying has had his own career resurgence here. You know, it's so very close to getting a shot at the Intercontinental Championship. It's just got to get past Finn Balor, which is no easy task. Bobby Hall is an extremely, you know, accomplished star we have here on SmackDown.
Yes, the trusty baseball bat. Could that be, Tim, the equalizer he needs against the Good Brothers here tonight?
Very well could be the equalizer he needs. I mean, it's not exactly legal to use in the match, but, you know, if the opportunity strikes too, well, use it, pun intended, may very well go about implementing it into the match.
Well, Bobby Hall, of course, as we said, former SmackDown Money in the Bank winner, of course. Again, has been off the radar a little bit last season, but this title tournament has brought out the best in Bobby Hall.
Yeah, it certainly has. He's brought out the best in both the competitors in the finals here. And so who is going to Backlash to meet Gilberto? Let's find out.
Here we go. We're underway. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, remember you can bet against or with Tim, of course. That is entirely up to your decision. Let's see what Tim has to say about this opening contest.
No, I think I have to go with Finn Balor tonight. I think he's the one who's had the biggest career resurgence. I think he's the one who's, you know, done the best in terms of the matches he's come through. And he does have the numbers advantage with the Good Brothers out there.
Of course, Luke Gallows and Carl Anderson.
Of course.
And of course, remember, ladies and gentlemen, if you are wanting to play the Biscuit Experience at the end of tonight's show, make sure you retweet the official NSW tweet. It is, of course, up on our Twitter page. Where else would it be? Of course, if you need any reminding, it will be in our Twitch chat. Round about now.
And so, are we going to see 10 of the biggins?
Of course we are. What a way to start SmackDown here tonight. 10 of the biggins, 10 points for our Twitch chat.
You gotta love it.
There's a kick into the midsection by Bobby Hall. Float over DDT, spiking Finn Balor into the mat. And Bobby Hall in control early on here.
He really is. The controls. Oh my goodness, just a big knee into the chest there. And now, kick it to someone's Bobby Hogan planned here. Oh my goodness, what a leg drop.
Into the cover, Bobby Hull looking to advance to Backlash. Not going to get it on this occasion. We've got three title tournaments to come tonight, Tim. This is just the start of the first one and a super kick.
Oh, square in the jaw of Finn Balor. And he could be in real trouble as Bobby Hull now. Look at these nasty punches. And now, oh God, the elbows.
Mounting Finn Balor and just laying down the punches, the elbows. And Balor now in all sorts of trouble here. Bobby Hull looking to finish him off. But no, Finn Balor slips out the back door. And Bobby Hull almost decapitates himself on the top rope and is out to the outside.
My goodness. That's very bad for Bobby Hull. But yeah, he's now cornering the outside. And Finn Balor's going to look to join him out there. Could be a mistake for Balor though as he gets dropped face first onto the hardest part of the ring.
Stand up.
Yes.
You've still got that blue suit on, has he?
I'd have 20 of these, remember?
That is true as well. Oh, what a German suplex on the floor. No padding on the outside. And Bobby Hall making Finn Balor pay early on. And now, oh, come on. Whoa, Jojo, come on. Jojo and that freaky man on the outside. And Finn Balor, I think, fell over when he got inside the ring.
Nothing signed up. Bobby was looking to take advantage. He has with the Dragon Sleeper locked in.
Balor in all sorts of... This could be all over for Finn Balor here. No, gets out of it. Big shot by Bobby Hall again here. And Brain Buster!
My goodness, just spiking Vivar's head into the mat with the Brain Buster. And... Oh, God, and he's got a bloody cup.
Old Dirty Hall. Cover. Hook of the leg to advance to Backlash to meet Gilberto El Rey. No. Just a two.
Finn Balor still got life in him, but really how much? That's Bobby Hall looking to end it now.
It has all been Bobby Hall this match. This to say goodnight to Finn Balor. And that is it. Cover, hook of the leg. Whoa, Carl Anderson.
Yeah, Carl Anderson getting a save there. But, oh, God, he's the face of Finn Balor. My goodness, he is a bloody mess.
He is a crimson mask. But wait a minute. Balor has Bobby Hall in the drop zone.
Certainly does.
Coup de grace! No way! After all the punishment! No! Bobby Hall gets the right shoulder up!
He sad does. You gotta think Gilberto's gonna be watching this backstage, loving this, seeing these two absolutely kill each other to try and get a shot against him at Backlash.
Bobby Hall in trouble again! Finn Balor going for one more time! Coup de grace! A second coup de grace! And Finn Balor is heading to Backlash!
I mean, give a huge assist to Carl Anderson when he distracted a referee. And Finn Balor, he is going to Backlash, but look at him, he is a bloody mess.
The chat went for Finn Balor as well, and it is a great night to be a member of the club as Finn Balor heads to Backlash to face Gilberto El Rey for the Intercontinental Championship.
Could be looking next to Connell Chamber, but Finn Balor's going to be going into that match not 100%. Gilberto's going to be fresh.
Wait, that is Jonathan King, of course. Oh, wait!
What the hell?
This Marcus Cutter again! This man who has been a thorn in the side of Jonathan King the last few weeks here. Just huge shots. Oh, my goodness me.
Backstage.
Wait a minute. Is that the Money in the Bank briefcase here? Cutter has now spotted it. Oh!
Oh, God!
This is ridiculous. One to the ass as well. And now Cutter's leaving with the briefcase.
Wait a minute. What the?
What the hell?
I mean, He can't just take that briefcase.
I think he is. Security are out of here.
Oh God, yeah, they're just running for their lives. They wouldn't know part of this.
Cutter's leaving with a briefcase.
Wow. Oh my God, well, I mean, that put that briefcase in his possession?
Well, hopefully we'll get something about that, ladies and gentlemen. Coming up next, Becky Lynch is going to take on Alex Vader. The winner of this match gets a shot at Sasha Banks at a Backlash.
Which of these two is key? Every game to Backlash to face Sasha Banks with the Women's Championship. What another great matchup we have here. The finals of now the Women's Title Tournament.
And introducing first from Ireland, she is the Irish Last Kicker, Becky Lynch.
And yeah, Becky Lynch has been up there before as being a Women's Champion, former Women's Champion. And you know, she's, I think I remember correctly, the previous person to challenge Sasha Banks for the Women's Championship but could not get the job done. Now she has an opportunity to, you know, get another shot at it, but first she's got to get past a hungry Alex Vader.
And of course, again, let's also talk about Alex Vader. Alex Vader was stopped by Sasha Banks becoming the longest reigning SmackDown Women's Champion, so there's history there as well. Becky Lynch though, looking to once again get a shot at that Women's Championship at Backlash.
Yeah, looking to do that. I mean, both these two extremely hungry to, you know, get that shot at the SmackDown Women's Championship and be fine with everything they've got.
And ladies and gentlemen, her opponent, she is Alex Vader.
Of course, yeah, they said Alex Vader was, you know, so close to, you know, getting the longest reign with the SmackDown Women's Championship that's still held by Alicia Fox.
Alicia Fox.
But of course, Sasha Banks stopped that from happening. Alex Vader has wanted, you know, the rematch of a sit, has wanted revenge. What's happened? So she's hungry to win the finals here.
And of course, ladies and gentlemen, again, you have to think, it's another sort of Sasha Banks watching this tournament, seeing how it's progressed. And of course, having the history of both these girls, Sasha Banks, of course, she's going to be well familiar with both of them. It is going to be very interesting to see who comes out on top here to face Sasha Banks at Backlash.
Oh yeah, well, I'm sure it's definitely be very interesting. Yeah, Sasha Banks is going to be watching this backstage very closely and say, yeah, there is history of both these women in the match.
Of course, Sasha Banks will be watching at a very strange angle backstage.
But of course.
As here we go, underway, and let's see who Tim has for this one.
No, I think I'm out to go with Alex Vader for this. I think she's just going to be the more hungry in this matchup. There's more, you know, go for when it comes to feelings towards Sasha Banks, of how Sasha Banks ruined her chances of becoming the longest reigning SmackDown Women's Champion.
So with that in mind, Tim, what does Becky Lynch have to do here to get the win over Vader tonight?
I think what she's got to try and do is, you know, use her submission expertise, you know, use her speed, because she's going to be the slightly faster of the two. But going to outside and get frustrated is not going to help. She's got to, you know, work over the arms, you know, lock in that disarmor to defeat Alex Vader.
Now, oh, look at this DDT on the outside. Goodness. That is the viciousness that Alex Vader brings to the SmackDown Women's Division. And we were just talking about, well, I was talking about in the intro, Tim, Mr. McMundo on Main Event this week said we are heading towards another draft after Elimination Chamber, so we've got a few weeks to go. Big times for everyone here on Raw and SmackDown.
Oh yeah, definitely huge times ahead. I mean, you know, we see these two within the ring right now on SmackDown. Who knows? After the draft, they could both be on Raw. One of them could be. Who knows? The draft brings up so many different elements of what can happen.
And of course, remember, if you were there for Main Event, as Raw and versus SmackDown each and every week on Main Event. We'll get that in a second. Hold on. Cover. No, just a one. Of course, we've seen Jay Mercer defeat Simon Keller at SmackDown. So Raw do take a 1-0 lead into the next week's show. Keep an eye out on who will be facing who this coming week, as Vader now looking to get back into this. No! Double-handed!
My goodness. And now
is she looking for that submission maneuver?
She's thinking, well, she hooks the arms here, you go for that scorpion cross lock, has it in.
And there is nowhere for Becky Lynch to go here, but Vader could not hang on.
And of course, Becky Lynch is a submission expert. She knows ways to, you know, get out submissions quickly and apply them effectively.
As anyone, even someone who Nelly was the longest reigning champion, can do with a Russian leg sweep.
Certainly can, and Becky Lynch has had some real struggle in this matchup to really get out the cape, and all that's going to help a big kick to the face. Right in the titties. Goodness, what a vicious DDT. Is now a cover hook off the leg. No. Beautiful suplex. Now Becky Lynch is feeling fired up that she can get back into this matchup. And no, but misses the clothesline. But Angus Rego's got something else planned. As now just a conversion of a crossface here, but not again. I said Becky Lynch is a submission expert. Oh my goodness. A huge backspike step, but now Becky Lynch, she's looking worn out. Yeah, it was the ropes. If the referee didn't notice that, he would have been blind as hell. All paid off.
And I forgot to unmute, so they haven't heard me for the last 5 minutes.
Oh dear.
Sorry about that, guys. I am still here, believers. As Lynch, now coming back here, and a mini. Still thought of a new name for that move.
A mini, you now were meant to go over.
Ah, well, we could call it that, I guess.
As a mini, you're going over.
Yeah, that's a good one. Big DDT into the cover. Vader.
That could be it.
Two, no.
She's still got fight in her. Could still go. And now, as you figure that Scorpion cross lock again.
Vader in a lot of trouble here. Hooked one, hooked two. Vader's got her locked in. Lynch has got nowhere to go. Surely this time.
Yeah, she's got for some way to escape, or she's going to have to submit and verbally because she can't exactly tap out.
But no, Vader still can't put Lynch away. Into the corner. And oh, Lynch with the big knee. Vader taking too long to come across. And another Plex!
Oh, it's another big Plex. And now, this could be it. Is Becky Lynch going to backlash?
Into the cover, hook of the leg to put away Vader! No! Still not.
Becky Lynch, she can't show no signs of frustration. She can't believe she hasn't put Vader away.
Vader back to her feet. Lynch is stalking Vader! Now she's got... the Disarmor center of the ring!
Yes, center of the ring is actually going to tap out here. Or can
yes, she is! And that is Becky Lynch going to backlash!
And Becky Lynch had to fight hard for the victory, but she's able to do it. Employed Disarmor, you know, expertly, got Vader to tap out, and she is going to backlash.
A huge win for the Irish last kicker. Becky Lynch gets another shot at Sasha Banks and that SmackDown Women's Championship.
Make it the second time be the charm for Becky Lynch.
And remember, ladies and gentlemen, SmackDown is part of 4 shows which you will see per week: Raw, Main Event, SmackDown, and NXT. Remember, after NXT this week, we will have Backlash pay-per-view. Make sure you keep an eye on Twitter to find out when it will go live. And also join us on all social medias, which includes Facebook and YouTube. Coming up next, it's time for CM Barnett, the Curfew Man, to take on the Velveteen Dream, Travis Soul. That's coming up next on SmackDown Live.
What a grand matchup we have coming up here. Which of these two is going to get a substantial victory? In a way, climb up the rankings.
And ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, he is the Velveteen Dream, Travis Soul.
He's one of the most charismatic individuals we have here in NSW, the Velveteen Dream, Travis Soul. A guy that's just, full of that confidence, full of that ego, however you want to word it.
A very long entrance.
Velveteen Dream. And long entrance, but he's don't want to shy away from how he feels.
Well, that we say, ladies and gentlemen, this very important for Velveteen Dream, of course, been on a bit of a losing streak recently.
So it's a chance in this matchup to, get a win and get the confidence back. Because, you beat someone like Curtis Barnett, it'd say a lot for you going forward, to defeat an NSW original.
Let's just hope next season they really cut this entrance down.
Let's hope. I was going to say that when it comes to the Velveteen Dream, Travis, he's been in NSW for many years. He's practically an original.
He is indeed, yeah, of course. He once had his head shaved at WrestleMania.
Ah, yes.
I can't remember the guy who did that.
It was Danny Six, wasn't it?
Sorry, I'll just take that line out of your mouth, will I? Goodness. Velveteen Dream ready for action here tonight. He has went through a lot here in NSW. Of course, he was the personal hairdresser, of course. Yes, with the Disney Alliance.
Yes.
Does hold the record for the most Russian leg sweeps in one match.
Yes, he got that at the Royal Rumble with, was it?
Seven?
Seven? Yes. I think it was seven.
Seven? And also has some fabulous abs.
Abs.
And what a hairstyle to match. Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, he is the Curfew Man, CM Barnett.
He doesn't care about hairstyles or, the ego you have on you. All he cares about is sending people to sleep. By hitting them, we've got to sleep, not by his match style.
Well, he just tells people that they have a curfew.
Yes, everyone has to have a curfew. I hear Kev Burnett wants to try and, become president so he can, bring an actual curfew into power.
Wow. I heard that he wants NSW shows to end at a reasonable time.
Yeah, he wants that. I mean, what kind of fool does he think he is?
Well,
theoretically, when it comes to years, we end in a reasonable time.
Well, there is some stupid people in this world. People actually call people British Winnie the Pooh,
yes. That's why I'm pretty sure Winnie the Pooh's British anyway.
That is true. So you need some lazy insurance.
I prefer, insurance that actually gets the job done. And actually puts effort in.
Probably got over by the half of the audience's head, but never mind.
Yep. Their reflexes weren't good enough.
Here we go then. We are underway. Trevor Soul and Curtis Barnett. CM Barnett, sorry. Give me his proper title. Who you got for this one, Tim? You're losing 2-1, so who are you going to go for?
I forgot to go with the NSW original, the Curfew Man, CM Barnett. As you said, the Velveteen Dream's been on a bit of a losing streak, so I mean, Chaos Bonnet can take, or CM Bonnet, whatever you want to call him, can take advantage of that fact.
And do you think that CM Bonnet can, in fact, put his curfew on any, a lot of these people here in Calgary tonight?
You know, I think he'd like to, and I think, you know, he's going to try to bring his power to, you know, make the curfew come into effect.
Well, Travis, so, look at this big backbreaker. Because, ladies and gentlemen, if you've missed any of the NSW shows, you can always go back and watch them on demand. You can actually watch every pay-per-view that NSW's ever done, if you're bored. And that is on our YouTube channel, of course. Just search for Nonstop Wrestling UK on YouTube.
Ah, yes.
Don't know why the UK, to be honest. I think it was the only one that was available at the time.
Probably. Because now... Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, for a minute. Oh. Mini Coast to Coast.
Yeah, a mini NXT special.
Into the cover. See a Bonnet looking to put away Travis Soul here. No, not going to even get a two.
I just realised the poor Raw brand doesn't have a special.
Maybe we have to think of one.
Yeah, you know, we have the SmackDown special, which is a swing. The NXT special, which is the Coast to Coast. What would Raw get? Power bomb into sexy pin into Boston Crab.
Oh my God! Isn't that unbreakable?
I think so.
Don't a lot of people cry about that?
Nah, true.
And whine like little bitches.
Yes.
Well, we'll see what happens. We'll come to that as we come to the red brand, of course, and CM Bonnet now looking to wear out Travis Soul early on, trying to dislocate that arm.
Yeah, and that is, you know, a smart tactic of CM Bonnet to do that, to go off the arm. The insurance, okay, I mean, because then that makes locking in the Anaconda Vice that much easier if that's the move you choose to go for to end things. But oh, what a close one into the corner. Oh, but, oh, God, into the ropes it looked like that Travis Soul just went.
Bonnet been in control for most of this match. Oh, there's that knee. And now... big clothesline out of the corner into the cover, hook of the leg.
He's got the leg hooked.
No, can't get him done though again.
And Travis Soul kicking out.
Big Joe Jacker by Travis Soul. You can see the height advantage Travis Soul has in this match, but not really helping him this time. And again, there's that big elbow followed by the running bulldog. CM Bonnet, can he put Travis Soul here? He's done a lot of damage here, Tim, but can he put Travis Soul away into the cover? Hook of the leg.
Just an easy kick. I mean, I think he can, though. CM Bonnet has a lot of experience in the ring. You know, he's set in SW Originals, been here from the beginning. But look at this. Could Travis Soul be looking for that purple Rainmaker elbow?
And he got it! Into the cover!
He turned his luck around.
No, not on this occasion.
CM Bonnet's still got life in him. He can still go. An old big knees into the back.
Travis Soul pointing to CM Bonnet. Can he put him away? As I said, it was his turn, but no, Bonnet coming back now. Curfew man still not out of this. Maybe trying to tell Travis Soul that he is feeling sleepy.
Yeah, maybe so. CM Bonnet now, he has Travis Soul ring, but he's not taking advantage. He's just waiting around here. That could be a huge mistake. Soul gets hit with a drop kick.
Oh, Travis Soul is feeling it now. The Velveteen Dream. Big forearm shot. Take a second one. And bow! Nice spine buster. Thrust those hips.
And he is thrusting, and now he's caught in the corner, but no, CM Bonnet dodges, but can't capitalize.
Again, that was just how quick Travis Soul is here. Bonnet, send out of the corner. No, drop toehold, Bonnet. Quick, too quick for Travis Soul this time. Soul, now dumped over to the outside.
Yes, and this is always where things can get very dangerous. Say that for us. Got the very thin padding, doesn't offer really that much protection. And you've got the barricade, the post, and there's still steps to worry about.
Big forearm shot by CM Bonnet. Referee up to a three count, plenty of time. Oh, look at this. Travis Soul caught CM Bonnet with stunning him across the top. And now, with the big back suplex.
A big psycho suplex now from Trevor Salters. Bringing Sam Bonalpo just raking at the eyes by the looks of it. And oh, goodness, just couching away brutality.
Travis Hall can get down and dirty when he needs to. But look at this. He's mocking him. He's mocking the curfew man.
Saying, oh, sleepy.
Sleepy time. And this could be the end for CM Bonnet. There it is.
The purple rainmaker elbow.
And Travis Soul gets the win. The Velveteen Dream gets the win here tonight.
A big win for the Velveteen Dream. Travis Soul is turning his luck around. This could be the start of big things for the Velveteen Dream.
And, well, Barnett, the chat went for Barnett, so nobody scores points on that one. It remains 2-1 to our Twitch chat in the predictions. Travis Soul doesn't care. He wants you to all come and experience the Velveteen Dream.
So it does. It's a big win for Travis Soul.
Back in the win column, Tim. It's big, big boost for Travis Soul. Wait a minute here. Eve Sparks. Tonight, we show Bailey that she does not mess with Fearless. And tonight, we show Maz and all the fans what they have been missing. And maybe we should take everyone out one by one. Tonight is just the start.
Yeah, we've seen these two now similarly on the same page together, you know, forming this interesting team up. And yeah, the women's division could be in real trouble.
Eve, tonight I take a Bailey and send a message to whoever wins a backlash that I am the SmackDown Women's Money in the Bank holder and I am waiting. But Eve, maybe we should ask Maz about some other women's titles to be brought back.
Oh, okay. That's interesting. I think I know what they're going for about women's titles being brought back. I wonder if Maz would go for it.
The tag team titles, maybe?
That's what I'm thinking.
Coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, before they meet at Backlash, it'll be Rutan versus Scott Dawson here tonight, one-on-one. The tag team champions, well, will be looking to get one over on the challengers here tonight.
Yeah, of course, these two teams have history with each other that will come out in a bit, but let's get this match underway.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, being coming to the ring by Bowen, he is Rutan.
And of course, Fallout and Revival are, you know, no strangers to each other. They have fought before with the tag team titles on the line, and they fought, you know, in singles matches. When it comes to actually the singles matches, Fallout have always had the upper hand over the Revival. Are we going to see that trend continue?
Indeed, there is. It could be a huge opportunity for the challengers at Backlash to get one over the champions here tonight.
It could be a huge opportunity and for that to happen, for the VNN to get one over and going to Backlash. And so Fallout, you know, they've challenged the Revival before for the tag team titles. It was at the Royal Rumble. He came up short. They have a second opportunity at Backlash.
Rutan and Bowen looking to become tag team champions for the very first time at Backlash. But can they get that momentum going forward here tonight?
That is a big question on the minds of many.
And his opponent, being coming to the ring by Dash Wilder, he is one half of the SmackDown Tag Team Champions. He is the Enforcer, Scott Dawson.
And Scott Dawson will be looking to get a big singles victory here tonight to give, you know, the Revival momentum going to Backlash. So that, you know, the aim is up. Of course, you know, Scott Dawson's got to figure the back of the mind. That, you know, whenever it's come to singles competition, him and Dash Wilder have not succeeded against Fallout, but tonight could be a very different story.
But the thing is, Tim, when it comes to the tag team championships, Revival were a step ahead of Fallout the last time out.
Yeah, they certainly were. So, you know, Fallout's got to learn from that. You know, change things up when it comes to the title match at Backlash.
Well, we are ready to go. Rutan and Scott Dawson. And we are underway. Tim, who you got for this one?
I feel personally have to go with Rune for this one. I think, you know, Fallout are going to have, you know, momentum going into Power Crash. When it comes to the singles competition, it seems that Fallout are quite unstoppable. And I think that kind of trend continues.
Anyone,
on.
Even someone who's a part of the Tag Team Champions, can do a Russian leg sweep.
But we know Scott Dawson will fight with everything he's got to make sure it's the revival with momentum going into Backlash.
And a nice hip toss there by Rutan. Very strange in the Tim that Fallout got them singles victory and then just couldn't get the job done when it came to the tag team. You would think with all the momentum they had, you thought it might have been on their side, but when it did come away there, as anyone, even someone who's a part of the Challengers, can do a Russian leg sweep. And going back to my point, sorry, as you see, you would think that the momentum was on Fallout side, but yet when it came to the championship match, they couldn't get the job done.
No, I couldn't, but I think, you know, the momentum, yeah, it was on their side, but doesn't mean they were essentially going to get the win. I think when the match came around, the revival, they were just that so much hungry to prove themselves in that matchup. You know, everyone pretty much said, oh no, you know, there's no momentum on their side. We're seeing new tag team champions at Royal Rumble and stuff. That fueled the revival to do everything in their power to make sure they retained. And they did just that.
Rooting with a big shot here on Scott Dawson. And there's that athleticism. Such a big man, Rooting. And he can move around the ring just like sometimes like a cruiserweight.
He certainly can. It is crazy to see what he can do as a cover in spear. No go there. Because, well, just making, you know, Scott Dawson use up precious amounts of energy.
Into the corner. And goodness, squashing Scott Dawson into the corner. And, well, I'll tell you, the revival not having the looking very good here tonight. There's a DDT by Rutan. Looking to put away Scott Dawson into the cover. Hook of the leg. No, two count only.
Just a two count. And Rutan showed signs of frustration, but he's got to know what it takes to put away Scott Dawson. It takes more than that to defeat him. He's now has the arm.
Big shot into the midsection. There's a second one. Third one will break the hold. Dawson needs to get some momentum here on his side. Big uppercut. That'll do. That knocked the big man off his feet. No, wait a minute here. Looking for a submission maneuver. Center of the ring.
We're trying to get Rune to tap out here, but no, Rune's trying to fight this off. And he finds an escape.
My goodness me, but has that the damage been done, even if it's been on for such a short time? But look at this, Rutan just picks up and big, big gut buster on Dawson. Bowen on the outside, very happy. Might not be happy now, though. Oh, Dawson ran into a brick wall.
Yep, he sure did. Whatever he had planned, it was, you know, no room yet. Just crashed into a brick wall. Wow. Oh, goodness, just stomping at the arm there with absolute viciousness. Now, Rune, what has he got planned?
And Rune just dumping Dawson to the outside. God, you've got to think, Tim, when this comes to Backlash, when the title's on the line, you've got to think Fallout are going to be up for this because they know that they knew what how they come up short the first time. The game plan has got to be different coming to Backlash.
It definitely has to be different. They've got to be, you know, more hungrier than ever to become tag team champions, to defeat the revival. Because, yeah, you know, at the Royal Rumble, pretty much everyone thought they were going to win as we have our bloody cuts.
Oh, my goodness me. Dawson in all sorts of trouble. Rutan may be looking for that Fallout deal. Has him up.
Oh.
The Fallout deal!
Or is it new? I can't remember.
Nuclear Fallout, same thing.
Nuclear deal.
Nuclear Fallout deal.
They both work.
Yeah, into the works. Cover to put away Scott Dawson. No, Dawson not going down. My goodness me. Look at this.
Now,
I think Root may be slightly peed off.
Yeah, I think so. You've got to think, though, the blood's now... Now, pouring out that wound, Scott Dawson has to be careful, you know. This big tactile defense is is coming up soon at Backlash. Can't really afford to go with an injury.
That is very true. And now, look at this. Into the guard this time to put him away. No, and again, Dawson refuses to give up.
God, but that way, he is a mess.
Yeah, but we've seen what happened to Finn Balor. It spurred Finn Balor earlier on tonight. But my goodness me. What kind of shape is Dawson even going to be in a Backlash?
I can only imagine he's just going to be in rough shape when it comes to Backlash. You could just see the blood is pouring. And it's going to weaken him. Could think Dashwater is not liking this one bit.
But it also shows the determination and the grit of Scott Dawson. Oh, but he got caught! And you're an Augie!
No, you're an Augie!
No, you're an Augie!
You're an Augie!
No, you're an Augie!
You're an Augie!
Well, we'll agree to disagree.
Oh, we're fine.
The attempted kick by Rootin doesn't find the mark. The punch does, though. Rootin. Now. Oh, my! No, come on!
No. Oh, God, we're going to see 10 of the biggins.
Oh, 10 of the biggins, and if his face isn't already a mangled mess.
There is blood all over that turnbuckle.
My God, we better get that cleaned for the next match.
Yeah, we better. That white NSW logo has turned red.
Oh, my God, look at this. Oh, but no.
Oh.
Clever by Dawson, but no, couldn't take advantage. And a belly to Rootin.
No one wins off that.
He might do, actually.
Oh, he's not done. Oh, brother.
brother. And now, Dragon. Surely the lifeless carcass of Scott Dawson. Just pin the man.
Yeah, just, it's a mercy killing.
My goodness me, I don't think there's going to be much left of Scott Dawson after this. A huge
clothesline. To go to a handicap match.
Oh my goodness, this has got to be it. And still, Scott Dawson says, not today, thank you.
Good Lord, yeah, he's fine with everything he's got. You've got to respect that, but I don't know how smart he is on the part of Scott Dawson.
Oh, and again, just bouncing off Rootin.
Yep. Body meets brick, and brick's going to win.
God. Rootin. Somehow, how is Dawson finding this energy?
I don't know. He's got the stamina of a horse.
Of a stallion. And now, Rootin's in trouble here, you know.
He is in trouble.
Oh, who gave this match this long?
I don't know. But again, just another big punch to our faces, opening that wound.
Dash, what are you doing?
I think he's cleaning that turnbuckle.
Yeah, but the problem is the referee's distracted. And, well, Rootin's now distracted. Dawson's back to his feet. And my God, there's going to be not much blood left for Scott Dawson at the end of this.
Nope. He has donated quite a bit.
Spin me right round, baby, right round. Dawson, cover. Using the ropes! Referee!
Yeah, ropes is leveraging. It's just not enough.
I don't even think he's got much energy left.
Jesus!
My God, Rootin's like, what do I need to do here? Well,
this could be it.
I think this could be the end. We hope, anyway.
One final nuclear deal.
Nuclear fallout deal. I like nuclear fallout deal much better. There it is!
The nuclear fallout deal.
Goodbye. Thank you for coming. Thanks for living. Cover. Hook of the leg. Oh, Scott Dawson.
Dashwater, what's wrong with you? Are you trying to get your taxi partner murdered?
Poor Scott Dawson is dead, ladies and gentlemen. R.I.P.
We don't need the local medical facility. We need the local morgue.
My God. Dash Wilder, you've got a tag team title match. A Backlash.
Yeah. Screw, you know, getting momentum towards the match. You know, help your tag team partner and just let the match end. Look at him.
By the way, I'd like to know whoever give this match this much time.
Yesterday, we are now informing you that you're fired.
Yes. As delete!
I've prepared the battlefield for a deletion.
I think Scott Dawson would hope to be deleted. I think he's trying to get his wits about him, but dumped to the floor again. This is what. How is he still fighting?
I don't know.
I think he's trying to leave. I don't blame him. Leave,
so,
Scott.
You know what? Fuck this shit. I'm out.
Go, run, Scott. Just leave. Go to the back. Oh no, he got caught.
Oh no!
Big backbreaker.
Is that to the back now, y'all?
To the back. Seven count.
Root went nope.
Rooting. Throwing him back inside the ring. Scott Dawson. Dash Wilder trying to get him. Oh, right across the cut.
Good lord.
Like, how much blood can a man...
I think we should cut some of this match.
Cut, literally, I get it. Let's see what he did there. Dawson. Somehow. Well, every time he tries to get any momentum, Rootin is just... Again, the drop. Rootin. Rootin will be beside himself that he hasn't put this match away yet.
Yeah, he's got to be shocked. He has a time. Wait a minute.
Well, whatever's good for one is good for the other, I guess.
Yep, we see 10 of the begins.
My goodness, this Twitch chat's been well and truly gifted tonight.
Evan, could that have just knocked out Rudin?
No way. No, of course not. This match isn't going to end anytime soon.
Nope.
Oh, no! Come on!
God.
Oh, of course Dash Wilder's going to get up. I feel like we've seen this spot before.
Yeah. So like a repeat. Oh, just end it.
No, wait a minute!
Ah! Oh, he's all caught up in the ropes.
Dash Wilder's like, look at me. Oh my. This is crazy.
A balls to the arm.
That is... Ref!
Referee, Jesus.
Two can only.
I mean, I can't believe Scott Dawson. He's got to be blind as hell with how much blood has gone into his eyes.
Ah, we've got another bloody cut. Oh, well, it was only a matter of time, to be honest. The blood out of these two, my God.
Are we sure we didn't book a death match by mistake?
I think so. Just to let you know, 93.3 went for... Oh, my God, no way.
Jesus Christ. Yep, apparently we're booking death matches now.
Dawson, what are you doing? Superplex!
Jesus!
And they're both dead.
Yep.
Well, the tag team title match is now a singles match.
Yeah, I think so. Because you can see Bowen tried to help his partner, but he didn't do anything.
Rootin could be out here, you know.
It could be.
For the most unlikely thing, he got him!
Oh my God!
Scott Dawson, the enforcer, the miracle man!
He's the enforcer, now he's the miracle man. Oh Jesus, we just went inside Dash Wilder, that was quite a view.
Oh well, there's always a bright spark, I guess.
look at him.
Scott Dawson with 6.7% of our Twitch chat guessing that. Wow, that's all I'm saying. Well, ladies and gentlemen, of course, remember, if you have Twitch Prime, you can subscribe for free. Or if you don't have that, $4.99 will get you a nice little Twitch subscription for us, and you get a big boy emote. Also, why not join us on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter as well? All support of NSW is welcome, and we love yous forever.
Aye. Oh, yeah.
Coming up next, who is gonna face Georgie Mack at Backlash? Will it be the All-American Connor Rhodes? Or will it be the Cage, Daniel Cage? We will find out. It is the final of the World Tournament coming up next.
What a match coming up next. Now, who is going to Backlash to challenge Georgie Mack? Left these two have been through incredible matches to get here to the finals, and then we get to find out who is going to challenge for the World Heavyweight Championship.
Introducing first, he is the Cage, Daniel Cage.
Now, we speak about, resurgences for people, Talk about Daniel Cage and a real resurgence in his career, Nice UCs has been a bit of a slow parts for him. Hasn't really, you know, done much, but now he seems to have really bounced back. He's in the finals and has a chance to, you know, go on to chance for the World Heavyweight Championship.
Yeah, he has had a few really barren seasons, but my goodness me, Daniel Cage has bounced back. What an opportunity for Daniel Cage if he can get past the All-American here tonight and once again have his millions
and millions
of the Cage fans back him up at Backlash. He is one step away from once again fighting for the world title.
Oh yes, yeah, he would be getting the opportunity against George Baptier once he become World Heavyweight Champion to once again be the top guy on SmackDown to truly prove himself. Boy, does he look focused.
Apologies, ladies and gentlemen, if you're in our Twitch chat and you are looking for the card. Apparently we've done a mistake, and that is the tweet for Risk It for a Biscuit.
Oh dear.
Or the Biscuit Experience. So there's no card, I'm afraid. Apologies.
Oops.
Well, you know, it happens.
That's true.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, he is the All-American, Connor Rhodes!
But another individual who seems to, you know, really have caught a
resurgence. We the people! Sorry.
It's Connor Rhodes, you know, recently he returned to NSW and since then has been a man on a mission and has been destroying the competition. And now he's in the finals to try and go for the World Heavyweight Championship. Say a lot of people going for this guy to be Georgie Mack's next opponent at Backlash.
And Connor Rhodes has been destructive since he's come back. Of course, he's taken out Danny Six. He made it his mission to do that. And now, in the final, one match away from getting the shot at the World. And what a return story for the aggressive real American.
He's certainly being extremely aggressive on it upon his return.
And here we go. Well, yeah, of course, in the tweet, of course, is the match card. So if you actually looked at the tweet, you would actually see the match card. Still to come, of course, Kimberly Blight versus Bailey and Georgie Mack versus the Yes Man, Daniel Bryan. But of course, Georgie Mack will have been watching this match at a very awkward angle.
Ah, yes, of course, as always.
Daniel Cage, big a rainmaker.
Huge rainmaker.
But that, I can see this aggressiveness from Connor Rhodes. Of course, we haven't seen anything of Danny Six in the last couple of weeks, of course. And since Connor Rhodes made it his personal mission, he's even gloated about it in recent weeks. Really, what do you make of Connor Rhodes since coming back, Tim?
You said he's come back, you know, hungry, extremely aggressive, and seems to be a man with a real chip on his shoulder. And that is what is going to, you know, this point is that chip on his shoulder.
And who, by the way, who are you going for in this match?
I was going to mention that. And, well, I just said about Karan's chip on his shoulder. Well, because I'm actually going to give it to Daniel Cage. I think he is focused on one thing and one thing only. That is becoming World Heavyweight Champion again. Well, Conrad has got these other little things going on in his mind, especially with the way he, you know, decided to target Danny Six. So I think that could be something that plays in the back of his head.
So who did you go for?
Daniel Cage had to go for, because he's focused on one thing.
Well, see if that is the case here. But Conor Rhodes, see, it's very strange how both these men have had such a big history here in NSW. Coming back and now the resurgence in season 7, it just shows you that the cream really does rise to the top, even though depending on how long you've been here.
So he does an old big spine buster by Daniel Cage.
Can Cage do it? Can this be enough? Come on, ref!
A bit slow there.
No, not on this occasion.
Two count.
You have to think though, Tim, Daniel Cage could have finally got to that final match if it wasn't the ref. Now he's stalking him. You know what this is? Oh no, Connor Rhodes stopping the Cage bottom.
Yeah, he countered that Perfectly as a beautiful counter, the attempted cage bottom. Now we'll jump to the outside.
Now where's Conor Rudd? Now looking to do more damage, as you see. Backlash awaits. Georgie Mack awaits, the world champion. Of course, one of these two men have went through the tournament, have got through two matches just to get to this stage. And seeing Tim, for one of these men, it's going to be really a very hard luck story getting to this stage and falling at the final hurdle.
It's going to be a real tough break. One needs to depend on who it is. Again, so far, and it just falling short.
Cage stalking Conor Rudd, and now looking at this, looking for the submission.
He's got the Dragon Sleeper locked in.
But no, again, Rudd's big knees stops Cage in his tracks, and now Rudd's just picking him up, and oh, shoulder breaker.
A vicious shoulder breaker by Conor Rudd.
Back and forth again. Now Rudd sends him into the corner. Is he going to... No, I thought he might have went for that. But oh my God, guys, come on!
Jesus Christ, this isn't deathmatch wrestling.
This is the new SmackDown special.
Oh my!
Oh Jesus. My God, another superplex! What are the wrestlers on tonight?
I don't know. They've been watching something backstage that's, you know, riled them up.
Crowd here in Calgary have had seen it all tonight. But Cage, wait a minute, Cage has got back in here. And a big snap suplex of his own here.
Yeah, sudden snap suplex. He's got right back in. So despite being superplexed to the outside.
I'm sure these guys just don't even know what they're made of. Sometimes we've seen things. Wait a minute, a spine buster out of nowhere. Wait a minute. Uh-oh. Are we going to see it? The Cage Peoples. Elbow!
Who is the electrifying move in NSW?
Cover! No hook of the leg! Does he need it? Mistake. He doesn't!
No,
Daniel Cage is going to Backlash and will take on Georgie Mack for the world title.
There, a huge victory for Daniel Cage. His resurgence continues on. A monumental victory, and he now gets the match with Georgie Mack for the World Heavyweight Championship.
The Twitch chat went for Cage as well. It's 3-2 to the Twitch chat with two matches left. Tim is still behind, but Cage doesn't care about any predictions. He cares about going for that world title and Backlash.
He certainly does, and it's a huge victory for Daniel Cage.
Hey, what a night we've had so far. Still some great matches to come. And, well, let's go through some of the Backlash matches. You will see it coming up. Of course, the SmackDown side of things has took shape now. We now know who's going to face who, Tim. And, well, this card is looking stacked from both Raw and SmackDown. And you've got to be saying, after what we've seen tonight, my God, I don't know what's going to happen to Backlash.
I don't know either. Yeah, it's an absolutely stacked card. And, yeah, this is just one of the many matches.
The Intercontinental Championship on the line is Finn Balor takes on Gilberto El Rey.
Yeah, Gilberto is going to be taking on a tough challenger, Finn Balor, who went through a grueling tournament to get to this stage. What kind of condition is he going to be at Backlash? Gilberto will take advantage.
Talk about condition, what is Scott Dawson going to be like? Is it the Revival take on Fallout with the SmackDown Tag Team Championships on the line?
It's not just Scott Dawson's condition, it's also Rudin's condition. Both those two went through an absolute war, you know, early in the show. And now, well, the Backlash of titles will be on the line.
Of course, the SmackDown Women's Championship is on the line. Becky Lynch once again gets another shot at Sasha Banks. Can it be second time lucky for the Irish last kicker?
And that is what we'll see, whether it be the second time lucky if Becky Lynch can do it and become women's champion, or whether Sasha Banks will yet again get a huge retain and continue well her reign.
And of course, it is now confirmed that Georgie Mack will take on the Cage, Daniel Cage, for the NSW World Heavyweight Championship.
He said the resurgence of Daniel Cage continues on, and will it be the dreams of Daniel Cage coming to fruition at Backlash and become world champion? Will Georgie Mack crush those dreams?
We will find out. Coming up next, Kimberly Blythe takes on Bayley after the attack backstage. Bayley demanded a match. Kimberly Blake will be looking to once again mark her new authority here on SmackDown.
Yeah, it seems Kimberly Blake's taking a real change in perspective and is now joined up with East Sparks. It's very interesting.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first being coming to the ring by East Sparks. She is SmackDown's Miss Money in the Bank. She is Kimberly Blake.
Yeah, well, this is very interesting. These two now have joined forces together and really changed their perspective of things. And Kimberly Blake, well, she's looking to destroy Bayley here tonight. And really, I think, sent a message to Sasha Banks at the same time.
Yeah, because remember last week, these two girls formed a partnership and then attacked Bayley backstage. And Sasha Banks coming for this here. What do you make of this partnership, Tim?
It's very interesting, this whole partnership. It seems both these two, you know, be frustrated that they feel they've been left behind, sort of forgotten about, despite Kimmy Blight is, you know, SmackDown's Miss Money in the Bank. And now, well, they've had enough of looking to destroy the women's division here on SmackDown.
And of course, they say they're known now as Fearless. And well, apparently they're going to ask Maz to bring back a certain women's tag team titles.
Very interesting.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, her opponent being coming to the ring by the SmackDown Women's Champion, Sasha Banks, it's Bayley!
Ah, yes. Woman, well, who loves to hug her.
She's so definitely a hugger.
Well, be looking for revenge here tonight. We'll see if she can score revenge, though, against Kimberly Blight.
It's your friends!
Where?
There! The inflatable Tim Price Bayley buddies!
They're not my friends, they're inanimate objects. You can't be friends with them, and if you are, you're a sad fuck.
Oh dear. Well.
Jeez.
Bayley, ready to go tonight, of course. The hugger, ready to go here tonight on SmackDown Live.
Yeah, she says she's all about that hug life. I prefer fug life.
Got some a tweet earlier on from Kimberly Blake saying she's looking to take out the hooker here tonight. I think she got it wrong.
Nah, it does sound a bit incorrect.
Yeah. That is right. People are saying you're not PG, Tim.
What's PG and why should I follow it?
Sure. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Underway. Let's see who gets the early advantage. Of course, Kimberly Blake's still a SmackDown Women's Championship. Still SmackDown Money in the Bank. So Sasha Banks has got to have eyes on the back of her head here as well.
Yes, certainly has to. We'll certainly have to have eyes on the back of her head at Backlash. Just say, in that contract stage, you can cash in whenever you like. So, you know, it's all to play for Kimberly Blight when she decides to cash it in.
And we have seen it on the Raw brand, of course, two successful cash-ins. Both, well, we were going to say Jonathan King has his, but he doesn't have his.
No, he has been stolen by Marcus Cutter. To the point where even security decided to back off.
Well, be interesting to see how that goes, and be interesting to see what Maz says about that situation. Into a quick cover here by Kimberly Blake. Referee didn't even decide to count, which was odd.
That's a very strange one.
Twitch chat getting behind Bayley in this contest. I haven't even asked who you thought was going to win, Tim.
Well, I need to get ahead of the fans, I guess. So I'm going to go with Kimberly Blake to win this then. I think, you know, she's on this mission to destroy the women's division. I think Bayley's going to be the first victim.
Yeah, Bayley in control here. Dragging Kimberly Blake. We what it would be for Bayley to defeat Kimberly Blake here. Just make her own mark here. Maybe just say, look, I'm still in this division. I can still challenge. Of course, Sasha Banks being a best friend, of course, really doesn't mean anything when it comes to the championship.
That really doesn't mean anything, you know. When you're champion, you got to sort of, you know, throw friendship out the window in order to, you know, keep ahead of the competition.
Bayley sending Kimberly Blake in and bang, clothesline into the corner.
And then staring down, he suppose Bayley was there.
Oh, look at this. A nice block by Kimberly Blake in the big suplex. As I say, this new found partnership. As I say, Eve Sparks Of course, he sparks knows about being SmackDown Women's Money in the Bank, of course. Failed to cash in when she had it. So, of course, if she's now helping... Oh, my God, Kimberly Blight. Blight with a kick. My goodness. The girl from the Netherlands, of course. And, oh, my God, look at the arrogance.
There's such arrogance being shown.
And she sort of fell off. Oh, no. Let's just forget
very
we saw
interesting.
That. As a monkey flippins.
Oh, big monkey flip.
Bailey. Now knowing that she has Kimberly Blight here. This could be a chance for Bailey to really hammer home the advantage here. Oh, look at this. Pussyplex.
Oh, Ritz. Grab a bar by the pussy.
Right by the pussy. Into the corner. Surely the beginning of the end for Kimberly Blight. No, went for the hug. The belly to Bailey, the hug to Bailey. I have no idea. But all she got is knee.
Yep. Knee to face. And now Kimberly Blight's looking to end things. Has her up.
And go! She calls that the devastating Dutch TKO.
Oh,
and
my.
That is not it.
No.
Wow.
Oh, kicking out. Showing she has a heart and determination to keep on going.
Well, we have seen so much here tonight, Tim. I honestly believe that you never know when matches can be over because these superstars just don't know when to quit.
No, they certainly don't.
It's up and over. And Bailey follows it up with a big shoulder tackle. And down goes Kimberly Blight to the outside.
And down to the outside. Absolutely vicious there. And so Bailey could get really dangerous on the outside, but so could Kimberly Blight. So many ways to
do it.
Stupid!
Bailey showed a bit more aggression here, and this is what she needs to do against the threat of Kimberly Blight. Sasha Banks has just looked up as back inside. Nah, she's really happy with that.
Yep, she sure is.
And look at this, Bailey now setting up for something big here. Maybe not.
Ah.
That was
anticlimactic.
I'll beat you to it. She did the deal!
The Michinoku deal, and she kicked out at one.
Wow! She must be fearless.
Must be.
My goodness, me back and forth. Bailey. Can she put away Kimberly Blight? No, Blight come back. Deep arm drag. Now, Bailey back to her feet. Though. Both girls... back and forth here, and a big hurricane runner by the hugger, and Kimberly Blight taking a rest, and I think she needed it because she was in trouble.
Yeah, she was in real trouble. And now get back in the ring though. Can she take advantage? Oh no, she has caught her.
Yeah, she has
down into the ropes.
Yeah, the back of Bailey's head hitting the room. Bailey may have just injured her back there, struggling to get to her feet. Kimberly Blight with a big knee, and now Bailey, after that, is in all serious trouble.
Certainly is.
The Dutch TKO!
It's it again.
Cover, hook of the leg. And this time, Kimberly Blight picks up the win. And wow, that is a statement to our women's champion.
Certainly is a huge statement. And Sasha Banks here not looking happy. A message has just been sent, though. By Kimberly Blight.
And the chat also went for Blight.
Oh, damn it!
Well, you lost anyway. Ladies and gentlemen, coming up this week.
Oh, I went for Blight too.
Rob Dundee is going to take on TJ Black on NXT in a non-title action. The longest reigning NXT champion looks to continue his dominance over the NXT division. We'll find out if that will continue in singles action this week on NXT.
Be a huge opportunity for TJ Black on this edition of NXT. Oh, I'm not happy with you.
Well, coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, the Yes Man, Daniel Bryan, is going to take on the World Heavyweight Champion, Georgie Mack. It is your main event, the SmackDown, coming up next. Why are you not happy with me?
It's quite an opportunity for Daniel Bryan. And when you said about the start match, you said that the fans are supporting Bayley.
They changed their mind. And ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, he is the man that likes to say yes, Daniel Bryan!
Yes, man himself, Daniel Bryan. I mean, this is a huge opportunity for him. If he could defeat Georgia backer, current world heavyweight champion. Well, he could maybe be the next in line for a title shot after Daniel Cage. I mean, it all depends on what, of course, happens at Backlash, because we don't have rematches around here. So Georgia Beck does get dethroned. Well, we could see Daniel Cage versus Daniel Bryan.
And here comes a few yes jokes. I went and talked to Daniel Bryan today, and I said, Daniel, are you looking forward to this match? And he said,
yes.
Did you speak to Daniel Bryan today?
Yes, I did.
And?
And I asked him, you know, do you truly believe you could defeat the World Heavyweight Champion Georgie Mackey tonight? And he said,
yes!
Of course!
There's your Daniel Bryan yes jokes!
As the fans all say yes in unison, brainwashed idiots.
Last chance to bet here tonight. Can you beat Tim? 3-2 up for the Twitch chat. Tim can only hope for a draw. We'll get to his prediction in a minute, because ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring, he is the World Heavyweight Champion, Georgie Mack.
Georgie Mack is a guy who's, you know, keen on something, you know, a two-time World Heavyweight Champion. Now this is his second reign. Because now he knows that Backlash should be taking on Daniel Cage and trying to defend that gold around his waist. But right now he's got to focus away from that and focus on the man in front of that, him, and that is the yes man, Daniel Bryan.
Now you've got to think, Tim, Backlash just around the corner. You're right, Georgie Mack is surely not going to be focused 100% on this match.
No, certainly no idea. No, he has to be, but I don't think, yeah, he will be. There'll be a part of his mind that will be looking ahead, looking at Daniel Cage and the challenge he presents for the championship that is around the waist of Georgie Mack.
Well, here we go. Non-title action for SmackDown this week. Tim, who are you going for?
You know, I think you're like, I have to go, you know, with the World Heavyweight Champion, Georgie Mack. Yeah, his focus may be a little bit elsewhere on Daniel Cage, but, you know, he's got a point to prove here today. He needs to go towards his big defense of Backlash, and I think he could get that, you know, momentum against the yes man, Daniel Bryan. I just thought of something.
Go on.
So, if Georgie Mack locks in a submission,
yes,
logically the referee would go up to Daniel and go, do you give up?
Give up?
Wouldn't, by that logic, Daniel Bryan would have to say yes.
Maybe he just doesn't see anything.
But he's the yes man.
You know what? You're actually right there. I don't know how that works.
Quick, get him in a submission.
Or you could just kick him in the chest.
I'll do that. Yeah, that's effective.
Team, round about the same thing. Oh my goodness, Georgie Mack. Of course, Georgie Mack's not had the best of results recently as World Heavyweight Champion. He's suffered a few losses in tag matches, of course, and also suffered at the hands of Nova Mahal. You've got to be thinking that he really needs a victory here, Tim, maybe to just boost his confidence a little bit.
Yes, so he does. He needs a victory to, you know, as you said, boost his confidence, boost his momentum going towards Backlash with face Daniel Cage, because, you know, he's got to be seeing the resurgence Daniel Cage is having. He's got to be, you know, a bit concerned about that.
Oh, look at this. Oh, nope, leapfrog over. And a big knee by the yes man. And there he is, really happy.
So, so happy with himself. But old George Mack is right up.
Sends him into the corner. Mack with a big clothesline.
Huge clothesline into the corner. Now pick it up. Tenenbaum once again.
Oh!
Pop-up punch.
That could be enough to put away the yes man. No. And Mack, well, he's not. He can't believe he hasn't put him away.
Certainly can't. And now, though, this could put him away. Is he thinking of that sleeper hold?
Oh, yes, he is. If he falls back, it's all over. There it is. He's got it locked in.
He's got it locked in.
Oh, has he got it locked in?
Oh. I think, yeah, Daniel Bryan was able to escape, I think, just before the referee asked him if he wanted to quit.
That is very lucky on by the yes man. See, if I was a referee, I'd have run across there and went, do you quit? Do you give up?
Give up.
Oh, wait a minute. He has this famous yes kicks.
Levant's going, yes, along to them.
Do you like being kicked? Yes, you do! He has one for your noggin!
And as if he could have that big yes lock, if he can get locked in, George Beck could be in trouble of tapping out.
But no, he went for a different route here.
He was trying to, but the strength of George Beck was too much and he breaks away.
Both men with arm locked again now. Brian with the back elbow. Going to send Mack into the corner. And oh, big kick into the corner. Look at the speed of the Yes Man.
Oh my goodness, such speed by Daniel Bryan. So impressive.
This match going back and forth. Daniel Bryan showing, of course. Daniel Bryan, the former World Heavyweight Champion in his own right.
He certainly is. He would love to get up to those heights once again. So if he defeats the current champion, I said that's got to put him up there as the next potential contender following Daniel Cage.
Yeah, Daniel Bryan has held the world and the NSW Championship. He knows how to get the job done. Looking to pin the champion, not going to get it on this occasion. This match has been back one way, then the other. Now, Bryan going to use that technical ability to just try and wear down the champ again.
He just grabbed the arm, just wrenching away at it.
And a big shot into the midsection. Goodness, and a drop kick again by Bryan. Bryan again continuing to show McEnroe. Oh, just a rake to the eyes.
And
the pop-up punch!
It's effective.
Whoa. Daniel Bryan's music. Not Daniel Bryan, it's Daniel Cage's music!
Daniel Cage's music, and now George Rex realizes he's distracted.
Daniel Cage, this happened. Why does Georgie Mack seem to fool for this every time? Well, has he fooled for it? No, he has. He turned around. Bryan, big Hurricane Rana.
Oh, beautiful Hurricane Rana.
And that could this be the downfall of the champion again? No.
Now George Mack able to kick out. God, I thought that was even going to be it for him, but uh-oh.
Yes. Knock your head off.
Oh, the big knee strike. Center of the ring, cover hook of the leg.
Two, and Daniel Bryan defeats Georgie Mack.
Oh my goodness, and this is not good for George Mack. He's got no momentum going into Backlash. And you got to say, now Daniel Bryan's defeated the current World Heavyweight Champion. That's got to impress Maz. He could be looking at the next challenger.
And the Twitch chat defeats Tim Price in the predictions.
God damn you all.
Twice, two shows in a row.
But we're in Canada, I meant to go over.
I tell you one thing though, Daniel Bryan very happy. Whoa, Georgie Mack behind Georgie Mack.
Oh,
he is not happy.
He is not, in the kendo stick being used to send a message.
I think Georgie Mack has had enough. He is sick of being, well, distracted and beaten, and now it is up to Georgie Mack, well, the World Heavyweight Champion, to defend that title come Backlash. And well, doesn't he look happy? And whoa!
Oh, boy.
There is the man he will face at Backlash.
Well, you know, that is what it's all about. I mean, Derek Cage, he wants the championship. Will he get it at Backlash? Well, you'll have to wait and find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for being a part of SmackDown tonight. As always, we appreciate the time to watch the show. From Dave Easton and, of course, Tim Price, who will say goodbye to the fans.
Goodbye, fans.
Tomorrow night, NXT. Keep an eye out for when Backlash will be going live on Twitter. Please do like, share and subscribe. Leave a comment on YouTube. Do not be fickle. And we will see you for NXT. Dave Easton, Tim Price. Bye for now. Bye.